Good morning, everyone. I am going to deliver a lecture on fundamentals of vibration. We all know that vibration is very interesting and important topic for students as well as for researchers. This is emerging topic of dynamics, and so here these are the contents which I follow during the presentation. So first we define vibration. What is the cause of vibration? What is the effect of vibration on mechanical system? Why we study vibrations? What is degree of freedom? How we can classify degree of freedom? We discuss about vibration analysis procedure. In this part, we will cover various steps of vibration analyzing and related examples. So now, what is vibration? So generally, vibration is an oscillations. That means the motion that repeat itself after some interval of time. So usually, mechanical component is a mechanical system that subjected to repetitive motion. I mean, they repeat their motion. So the vibration occurs in mechanical components that subjected to force which disturb from its equilibrium position and start vibrating. So we can say vibration is a type of oscillation and repetitive motions. Oscillations may be periodic and random. Periodic motion means motion of pendulum which repeat its motion in a fixed interval of time, and random means which have no fixed interval of time when it repeat motion. So for periodic motion is motion of pendulum, motion of shaft due to unbalanced force, and a random motion is like a motion of car. If there is a vehicle and it is moving on a road which is regular, so the transverse, the motion in a transfer direction due to irregularity of the road is random. So for example, you can see here the motion of pendulum which is moving about its equilibrium position, and equilibrium position is the rest position when we can say if pendulum leaves from some position, it will rest on this position. Therefore, it is an example of periodic motion. If it is vibrating with an angle of theta, then theta is your degree of freedom of pendulum. In another plot of figure B, you can see here, you can motion of irregular shape which is repeat its motion after some interval of time. In another figure C, you can see the response of random motion where we have not fixed interval of time. For example, there is a motion of road car which we have discussed in last slide. So next question comes in our mind, what is the main cause of vibration? Why vibration generate in mechanical system? So we all know that every mechanical system have spring and mass system. When any system have spring mass system, they are prone to vibration. If there is internal combustion engine and there is force generated inside the system, due to that unbalanced force, the system will vibrate. For external force, we can see here the example of ship. If ship is floating on a river or a sea, there are some kind of waves comes and strikes to the ship. That the tendency of that waves is random type. So this is the example of external force. In another example, you can see here, if car running on a typical road profile, it can vibrate due to two main reasons. One reason is internal, and another internal excitation, and another one is your external excitation. Internal excitation are generated through sorry, external excitation are generated through a regular rote file. However, internal vibration generate due to internal imbalance force due to engine parts, due to IC engine parts. So now come to the next part, effect of vibration. Effect of vibration, how they affects the mechanical system. Effect of vibration may be positive and negative. But for mechanical system, we do not want vibration. We avoid vibration in mechanical system. If there is vehicle, if there is automobile and there is railway. So if there is vibration in any of the system, it will give discomfort to the passengers. Suppose we have a turbine or plate for the vibration. So the vibration can cause fatigue failure in turbine blade. If there is a machine and it is support, it is on support and support usually mounted on a floor. If there is some vibration in machine, then machine transfer vibration to the support and support transfer passes the vibration to the floor, then the floor will vibrate. If there is a, some kind of worker working on a machine or moving on a floor, then it feels vibration. It will give some easiness to the worker. So moreover, the vibration, we have already seen that the looseness is also main cause of vibration in various connections of mechanical component. If vibration level is high, it can lose the fastener which can collapse the machine component. Similarly, for you can see for heavy centrifugal machines like as motor, turbines, reciprocating machines like steam and gas engines, where vibrations not required. If vibration generated in that type of machines, the machine will collapse. So we can say vibration cause more rapid wear of machine parts like bearings, gears, and also creates excessive bears of machine parts. So for example, if you are doing some operation in lathe machine, then if low tool is shattered due to some vibration, you cannot have desired surface finish. So here you can see two different pictures. In first one, bridges are collapsed due to some random vibrations, or we can say some wind excitations, and another picture you can see the failure of turbine blades due to some internal disturbance and some external excitations. So why to study vibration in mechanical system? It is totally indescribable. Sometimes we need vibrations, sometimes we don't want vibrations. So it depends on the application, what we are doing, what we are making. So in natural frequency, we all know that the natural frequency of vibration of machine or machine structure is that when the external frequency of any external force meets with the internal vibration or internal frequency of the system, and that system will be collapsed, and that condition is known as a resonance. So it's better for better best design to remove vibrations, to remove the chances, to remove the chances of vibrations at design stage. If it is not removes at the design stage, then it's after that it will destroy the system. It will destroy the system. It will harm your product quality. So, but if sometimes we can reduce vibrations, effect of vibrations by the help of some mitigation strategies, like as we use dampers. The main work of damper is to dissipate vibrations, we can mount through some kind of use some leather pads or some wooden structure, wooden frame structure, so that we can reduce the impact of vibrations, or but it is not possible. We cannot eliminate to completely vibrations from any system. In spite of detrimental effects of vibration, there is some positive side of vibration. It can also be used for some consumer and industrial applications. For example, vibratory conveyors, hoppers, sieves, compactors, washing machine, electric toothbrushes, dentist drills, crocks, and many more examples are there where vibrations is used for some applications which is related to industry or consumer. So it can also improve the efficiency of certain machining operations like welding, casting, forging. So these are the very positive side of vibrations. So this is very important topic, degrees of freedom. We all know that the number of independent coordinates to specify the configuration of the system is called degrees of freedom. And there are various examples you can see here. In figure, you can see the pendulum. The degrees of freedom of pendulum is one. In second figure, mass is attached with the ball through a spring which is having a cage stiffness, and the mass is constrained to move in only one direction. So the degrees of freedom of this mass is one. In next figure C, you can see some disc hanging through the rod, and it is rolling. So due to the motion is the number of motion of this disc is only one. There is no translation motion. So the degrees of freedom of this disc is one. In another figure, there are two masses, one mass attached to a ball with the spring of K1 stiffness, and another mass attached to a first mass through a K2 spring. So here we have two masses and two independent axes. So this is the example of 2 degrees of freedom. So any vibration system have 2 main elements. One is a spring and another one is your damper. So the purpose of the spring is to store kinetic energy, and the purpose of damper is to loss the energy or dissipate the energy. So basically, the main mechanism of vibration system is to transfer its potential energy into a kinetic energy and kinetic energy into a potential energy, so that if the system is damped, then some energy is dissipated in each cycle of vibration, and it may be replaced by some kind of external force so that the steady vibration is being maintained. So basically, the purpose of damping is to reduce the motion of vibration body and dissipate the energy of the system. So this is the classification of vibration. Vibration can be classified in many categories. So here we are considering some kind of classifications in the basis of energy. First is undamped vibration, where damper is not used, there is no energy is lost or dissipated. And next one is your damped vibration, where energy is lost. It means we are considered the damping effect in the system. And another one is linear vibration, where all the basic component of the systems, that is your spring and the mass, are behave linearly. So this is the basic. So here you can see various examples of vibratory systems. In last time we have discussed the any vibratory system have 2 elements. One is a spring, one is a damper. So in first example, when the pendulum swings to and fro through our strings, and it is attached to a strings have some kind of stiffness. So these are the example of undamped vibration. In a similar way, when a mass hanging, and it is attached to a spring. So we all know that the spring having property of stiffness. So when it goes up and down to a spring, so it's a store energy. So in this system there is no any damping effect we are considering. In the another example, you can see the string is generally having a stiffness. So this is also a example of undamped system. In figure B, you can see the suspension system, and every suspension system having a two elements. One is a spring, one is a damper. So here you can see the spring basically is a suspension spring, and the damper you can see shock absorber. So here this is an example of undamped system. So in another classification, and the vibration can be categorized in following categories. One is a non-linear vibration, where its components are behave non-linearly. In linear vibration, we can see that the components behave linearly. And deterministic vibration, if the value magnitude of the excitations acting on a vibratory system is known at any given of time. Right, and for non-deterministic or random vibration, when the value of the excitation at given time cannot be predicted. So deterministic vibration, we know the time, and for non-deterministic vibrations, we time cannot be predicted. It is kind of random vibration. So basically, the next part of the presentation, that is a vibration analysis process for physical system. Wherever we want to analyze any physical or any dynamic system, we first create a free body diagram of that system. After that, we create a mathematical model of that system. Model can be analyzed in terms of discrete model or in terms of distributed model. If the model is multi-body system, then all elements of that dynamical system are connected through a spring damper system, and that kind of system is termed as a discrete system. And in distributed system, we are considering a single element, and we are considering whole system as a single element. So there are four basic steps to conduct a vibration analysis. First, we create a mathematical model of physical dynamic system, then generate a differential equations of that system, and the differential equations may be ordinary or partial. It depends what approach we are adopting here. If suppose there is lumped or discrete analysis, then ordinary differential equations will be generated. In a third step, find the solution of these governing equations. Solution may be exact or approximate. It depends the type of differential equation. We are taking ordinary differential equation, or we can say we are considering a discrete system, then up to fourth order we will get exact solution of that system. If we are following continuous system, or we have partial differential equations, then first we convert that partial differential equations into ordinary differential equations through a model expansion and other kind of theorems like a separation theorem. After getting a solution, we start interpretations of the result. So there are various methods to generate a mathematical model. We already described in last slide the model will be developed in differential form. The various models which can obtain through a mathematical model, like as Born-Gamow model, FEM or FEA model. So these are the two type of mathematical model we can obtain through a given considerations. One is your linear, and another is your non-linear. So basically, non-linear models are simple to give solutions. However, non-linear models sometimes will certain characteristics of the system that cannot be predicted using linear models. So in order to create any mathematical model, we cannot create directly some models, some complex models. First, we create a lumped model of the system that we have some idea about response of that system. Then we increase the degrees of freedom of that model, or we can say increase the complexity of the system. So here we can see the example of forging hammer. This is a forging hammer. There is a anvil and there is a tub. So metal is capped to make it desired shape. So in that system there is elastic pad to dissipate the vibration level, which can be generated through a tub and the anvil. Now first we create the model with consideration of 1 degree of freedom, and then increase the complexity to enhance the degrees of freedom of that model. So in next figure you can see we increase the complexity of this of that system with increasing the degree of freedom of the whole. So in second steps we drive the governing equations that physical model. Model may be for 1 degree, 2 degree, it depends on what complexity we are considering. So there are various principles we can use here. There are various modeling techniques like as Born-Garb modeling and FEM techniques, FA techniques, which we have already described in the last slides. So first we draw the free diagrams of involvement of all the masses. The free body diagram of the mass can be obtained by the isolating the mass and indicating or externally applied force or reactive force or the inertia force, and the equations of the vibrating system are usually in the form of set of ordinary differential equations for a discrete system, which we have already discussed, and or for a partial differential equation for a continuous system or a distributed system. So generally we use the Newton's second law of motions for Newtonian equations, D'Alembert principles and the principle of conservation of energy for obtaining a governing equations of the system. So in the next step we generate the solution for that governing equations. So for solutions we used various equation solving softwares, or we can use a Laplace transform, Fourier transforms, or many matrix methods we can use here. So for next step we interpret the results, the interpretation of the solution of the governing equations. Solution may be in terms of displacement, in terms of velocity, or in terms of acceleration. It depends what we are representing our results, how we are representing our results. And suppose, for example, we are obtaining the right comfort level of the passenger or a driver. So we interpret the results in terms of acceleration, because for ride comfort as per ISO 26031 we need acceleration, peak values of accelerations. So in another example, we consider a rider, cycle with a rider. So here you can see develop a sequence of three mathematical models of the system for investing in the transverse vibration of the rider or the motorcycle. So we have some assumptions here. So here we are considering elasticity of the tires, damping of the struts in the vertical directions, masses of the wheels and the elasticity, and the mass of the rider. So these are the basic assumptions which we are considering here. So as we described in the last slides, first we generate a simple model. So we are considering here a single degrees of freedom, right? So after that we are considering we are increasing complexity. So to increase the precision of the results, so here we are considering both tires, front and the rear. In third term we are also increase the degrees of freedom again. So here we are in considering the individual mass of the rider. So here total we have 3 degrees of freedom of the system. So here these are the different views of multi-body systems. Here you can see a five mass body system. So here we are developing a physical system. We are considering five masses with attached with the five springs, and so this is the this is my research part where we are showing the human segment model. We have created a human gait model. So here whole body you can see in figure A in transverse plane, segmental plane, frontal plane. So we are considering leg segment. So here you can see we are converting our leg segment into a 7 degree of freedom model. So here you can see the whole view of bone graft model. So this model, this is the whole bone integrated model of 7 degree of freedom leg segment model. In this first part, upper part, you can see pelvis, thigh, calf, and the foot. Foot is the lowest part. So the purpose of this model is to obtain the mathematical equations and in terms of differential, ordinary differential equations or the partial differential equations. It depends on the complexity, and further we use these equations for the solution and define and find the behavior of the leg segments.